Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
I'm Dr. Chaya Sande, and this session is on viral diarrhea. Now, acute gastroenteritis is a common illness affecting infants, children, and adults with significant morbidity and mortality. Number of different microorganisms can cause acute gastroenteritis, like viruses, bacteria, and parasites. However, viruses are the most important cause of acute gastroenteritis, especially in children. Nearly 75% of the children in developing countries have an episode of viral diarrhea before the age of 1 year. Viral diarrhea are again an important cause of acute gastroenteritis in developed nations too. So, the objectives for this session are like this. At the end of the session, you will be able to describe the general characteristics of viral diarrhea, etiology of viral diarrhea, morphology and classification of viruses causing diarrhea, epidemiology and pathogenesis, clinical manifestations, laboratory diagnosis, and prophylaxis. Now, let us begin this session with a case scenario. A 7-month-old male infant was present to a hospital with a 2-day history of watery diarrhea and fever since 1 day. The infant was reported to have 12 watery stools which were bloodless over the previous 24 hours, during which he became unsettled. He was crying a lot and accepted only half of his usual amount of intake of fluids. There was no history of vomiting. The medical history of the infant was otherwise not significant. He had received routine vaccination as per national immunization schedule. However, he had not received any vaccine for rotavirus. The baby had started attending a daycare center 5 days back, as the mother was a working woman and had just returned to work after maternity leave. On the day of presentation, the physical examination revealed an alert but irritable, restless, and ill-appearing infant with a temperature of 39.5 degrees centigrade. Its blood pressure was normal, tongue was moist, anterior fontanelle was normal, and urine output was normal. On the basis of clinical examination, mild dehydration was assessed. The stool microscopy of this infant was negative for inflammatory cells. There were no red blood cells in the stool. There was no ova, trophozoite, or cyst seen in the stool. Stool was negative for pathogenic bacteria on bacterial culture. However, the stool sample tested positive for rotavirus antigen. So, diagnosis of rotavirus diarrhea was done, and the baby was managed with oral rehydration therapy. So, this is how any case of viral diarrhea is presented to a pediatrician. So, let us first see what are the general characteristics of viral diarrhea. Now, viral gastroenteritis has sudden onset which follows a short incubation period of 1 to 2 days. The clinical illness is similar for all viruses causing gastroenteritis. Stools are usually watery and loose. There is no mucus or blood in the stool. Fecal leukocytes are typically absent. Virus shedding occurs for 1 to 2 weeks in stool in most of the cases. Viral gastroenteritis is usually self-limited in immunocompetent persons. Sometimes asymptomatic or mild infections also occur, and viral gastroenteritis is also associated with respiratory symptoms. Now, coming to the etiology of viral diarrhea. Now, the viruses causing diarrhea, they belong to genetically diverse group of RNA and DNA viruses. So, basically there are 4 separate groups of viruses which cause viral diarrhea: rotaviruses, calyceviruses, astroviruses, and enteric adenoviruses. Certain other viruses like coronaviruses, human boca viruses, dentoroviruses, they are also believed to cause viral diarrhea. However, their exact role has not yet been proved. Now coming to rotavirus. Rotavirus is the most important cause of acute dehydrating diarrhea in children. The virus belongs to Rhoviridae family. It is a non-enveloped virus. It is an RNA virus with segmented genome. It has icosahedral symmetry. Approximately it is 70 nanometer in size. It has wheel-like appearance. In Latin, wheel means, rota means wheel. So because of wheel-like appearance, this virus is known as rotavirus. It possesses triple-layered icosahedral capsid. The double-stranded RNA, it contains 11 segments and each segment codes for a different gene product. It possesses 6 structural proteins, VP1 to VP4 and VP6 and VP7. And there are 6 non-structural proteins, NSP1 to NSP6. The structural proteins VP1 and VP3, they are present in the inner core or inner layer. The VP6, it forms middle layer. VP7 and VP4, they are present on the outer part of the capsid or outer layer of the capsid. So VP7, it forms the outer layer of the capsid, and VP4, it comes out of the capsid like spikes. There are 11 segments of double-stranded RNA. Now coming to classification of rotaviruses. So based on the antigenic composition of capsid component VP6, which is present in the middle layer, 7 groups of rotaviruses A to G have been identified. Out of this, rotavirus A is the most important cause of diarrhea in children. Now, this human group A rotavirus, it is again classified on the basis of nature of VP7 and VP4 antigens. Like influenza virus, a dual system of classification has been used. So, antigenic and genetic typing is used for classification of rotavirus group A. The antigenic characterization is done using monoclonal antibodies, and genetic characterization is done by RT-PCR using primers which target unique regions of VP7 and VP4. Now VP4 is a protease sensitive protein which is present on the capsid, and for characterization of VP4, genotypic system is employed. So there are 35 P types are identified, and they are designated as P1, P2, P3 like that. VP7 is a glycoprotein and it is characterized by antigenic characterization. 26 G types have been identified and they are designated as G1, G2, G3 like that. So any particular strain of rotavirus, it is designated by a G antigenic type and P genotype. So G1 P8 type is the most common type found all over the world. A new classification system based on nucleotide sequence of whole genome has also been developed for classification of group A rotavirus. Now coming to replication of rotavirus. Rotavirus is an RNA virus which replicates in cytoplasm. So replication begins with attachment. Attachment occurs by means of VP7 and VP4 antigen. It is followed by penetration. Uncoating of virus occurs, and first there is transcription of RNA for synthesis of plus strand, and this results in synthesis of mRNA. The mRNA gets translated into the formation of proteins, and it also transcripted for the synthesis of negative strand and positive strand. This is followed by maturation, that is formation of double-stranded RNA molecule and assembly in the cytoplasm, subsequently followed by the release of virus particles. Now coming to pathogenesis of rotavirus, several proteins of rotavirus are believed to be responsible for the pathogenesis. Most important is VP4, which is of major significance, NSPP4, which is a non-structural protein 4, it acts as endotoxin and induces secretion. So it is the first endotoxin that has been identified in viruses. This endotoxin, it causes cellular necrosis and atrophy of small intestinal epithelium. This results in reduction of the breakdown of carbohydrates and reduction in the absorption of carbohydrates. So there is increase in the osmolarity in the lumen, and that results in diarrhea. The virus particles, they are released from the damaged cell, and the number of particles may be as high as 10 raised to 10 particles per gram of stool sample. The viral excretion may last for 2 weeks. Rotavirus group A is a very important or leading cause of diarrhea in young children. It is a major cause of childhood mortality in developing countries. The infection occurs all round the year in India. Group B rotavirus, it has been reported to cause outbreaks of diarrhea in adults in China, and group C has been reported with diarrheal illness in Japan. The another group of enteric viruses is caliciviruses. Now caliciviruses, they are again RNA viruses with icosahedral symmetry. These are small viruses, about 38 to 40 nanometer in size. They are non-enveloped, and RNA is positive sense RNA. Now 9 genera have been identified in calciviruses, out of which 2 are very important. One is known as sapoviruses or saporo-like viruses. Initially they were known as saporo-like viruses, now they are known as sapoviruses. These sapoviruses, typically they have cup-shaped depression on the surface of the virus. The another genus which is important in caliciviruses is noroviruses. Initially they are known as norwalk-like viruses. These viruses, they have smoother surface as compared to sapoviruses. They are also known as small round structured viruses. These noroviruses and sapoviruses have again been classified. They are classified in genogroups and genotypes. So in noroviruses, 5 genogroups have been identified, G1 to G5, out of which G1, G2 and G4 are found in humans. Now 14 genotypes are identified in G1 genogroup and 29 genotypes are identified in G2 genogroup. Now genogroup 2 and genotype 4 is the most prominent strain of norovirus or most prevalent strain of norovirus. Similarly, sapovirus is also classified into genogroups and genotype. So 5 genogroups have been identified which contain 14 genotypes. Coming to the pathogenicity of caliciviruses, noroviruses can cause both common source outbreak and can also cause sporadic diseases. Norovirus can affect all the ages. The large outbreaks are reported in the close communities, like in hospitals or in hostels or in jails or in homes for elderly persons. In immunocompromised persons, the noroviruses can cause chronic diarrhea with increased morbidity and mortality, and there is increased shedding of virus in immunocompromised persons. Sapoviruses cause disease mainly in children. Sometimes they are also associated with diarrhea seen in adults. Coming to the third group of viruses, that is enteric adenoviruses. Actually, adenoviruses, they are known to cause infections in humans like respiratory tract infections and conjunctivitis, besides diarrheal illness. Adenoviruses are DNA viruses which are non-enveloped viruses. They have icosahedral symmetry and DNA is a double-stranded DNA. Human adenoviruses are about 70 to 100 nanometer in size. The capsid has 252 capsomeres with 240 hexons and 12 pentons. The adenoviruses are divided into 7 species A to G, out of which the species F is associated with gastroenteritis. So 2 viruses which belong to species F, that is adenovirus 40 and adenovirus 41, cause diarrhea in infants. These viruses Unlike other adenoviruses, they are fastidious. Coming to the fourth group of viruses causing gastroenteritis in humans, that is astroviruses. These viruses, they have typical star-like surface appearance, that is why they are known as astroviruses. They are again small RNA viruses, about 28 to 30 nanometer in size. They are non-enveloped viruses and the genome is positive sense single-stranded RNA genome. The human astroviruses, they are divided into 8 types, out of which type 1 is most common. Now, let us see the clinical presentation in case of viral diarrhea. The commonest symptoms associated with viral gastroenteritis are diarrhea, fever, vomiting, abdominal cramps, lethargy, and dehydration. Sometimes, the associated symptoms like headache, anorexia, myalgia, malaise, and nausea are also seen. Now, let us see the transmission and epidemiology of viruses causing diarrhea. Now, most of these viruses, they are transmitted by fecal-oral route, except norovirus, sometimes it is transmitted with contaminated food. The incubation period is short, about 1 to 2 days, except for adenoviruses, where the incubation period is long, that is about 8 to 10 days. The viruses mostly affect children, however, norovirus infection is seen in all age groups. Enteric adenoviruses cause infection in infants and in young children. The rotavirus infection occurs all round the year, but norovirus and astroviruses, they sometimes cause sporadic outbreaks. Rotavirus causes acute severe dehydrating gastroenteritis. Otherwise, the other viruses, mostly they cause mild to moderate gastroenteritis. The enteric adenoviruses, they cause moderate to severe gastroenteritis and they also cause hospital acquired infection. The virus shedding occurs for about 1 to 2 weeks in viral gastroenteritis. Now, let us see how to perform laboratory diagnosis in viral diarrhea. Now, the specimen collection is stool and preferably the stool sample should be collected within 48 hours of illness. The rectal swabs are not very good specimen for diagnosis of viral diarrhea. The specimens are stored at 4 degrees centigrade and should be promptly transported. If it is not possible, then the specimen has to be stored at minus 70 degrees centigrade. The other specimen that can be collected is serum. For the demonstration of IgG antibodies are available only. So, usually these tests are useful for investigation of an outbreak and seroconversion between acute and convalescent phase sera has to be demonstrated for diagnosis. In case of norovirus gastroenteritis, food and water can also be collected for demonstration of virus. The various methods used for laboratory diagnosis are direct detection of virus, which can be done by electron microscopy, antigen detection assay, and molecular detection assay. The second method is isolation of virus in laboratory, and third is serologic test. Now, coming to direct detection, electron microscopy is the method, though not very commonly used. It is an important method of diagnosis of virus gastroenteritis. The virus particles must be present at a concentration of about 10 raised to 5 to 6 particles per ml of feces. The stool specimen, it is stained with 2% phosphotungstic acid and the virus particles, they appear as a lighter structures seen against the dark background. The advantage of electron microscopy is that it is simple and it can be done fast and the simultaneously different viruses can be detected. So, you do not have to specifically look for a particular virus. So, that is the most important advantage of electron microscopy. The disadvantage is that the availability of infrastructure, high cost of the instrument and the expertise is required for identification of virus. Again, this method has moderate sensitivity and specificity. So, So this is the appearance of different viruses causing gastroenteritis under electron microscope. The rotaviruses, they have typical wheel like appearance, so they can be identified by their characteristic morphology. Astroviruses, they have distinct 5 to 6 point star appearance, so that helps in the identification. Adenovirus typically has space vehicle like appearance, so that helps in the identification. Sapovirus, they have cup shaped depression on their surface, which gives them Star of David appearance, so that helps in identification of sapovirus. Noroviruses, they have relatively less rigid surface, so their surface is relatively smoother. So under electron microscope, different viruses can be identified based on their morphology. Immunoelectron microscopy can be done to increase the sensitivity. So here, stool suspension is mixed with virus specific antibodies, which results in the aggregation of virus particles and the identification becomes easier. So the technique becomes more sensitive. Another method of diagnosis of viral gastroenteritis is antigen detection. So various antigen detection assays are available. The most commonly available assays are enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, latex agglutination test, and rapid membrane based immunochromatographic assays are available. For carrying out this test, the suspension of stool in phosphate buffered saline is prepared, 20% suspension is prepared, and it is used for carrying out the assay. The advantages of antigen detection assays are that they are rapid, inexpensive, and simple. However, the most important disadvantage is that they are not available for all the viruses causing gastroenteritis. Again, the sensitivity is not very high. So, low and moderate sensitivity again limit their use in the diagnosis of virus gastroenteritis. The other methods available are the molecular detection assays. Actually, polymerase chain reaction is the most sensitive and specific test available for diagnosis of virus gastroenteritis. Real-time PCR and reverse transcriptase PCR is the most sensitive method, and here the simultaneous detection and quantification of virus is possible when the test is being carried out. Another assays like isothermal amplification assays like LAMP, NASBA are also available, and DNA sequencing can also be done for detection of viruses causing gastroenteritis. Isolation of viruses is not routinely carried out because most of the viruses causing gastroenteritis are fastidious, so they do not easily grow or do not grow at all in culture, so it is not routinely used. Rotaviruses, they can be cultured in cell lines like MDBK, PK15 and BSC1. However, the culture medium has to be supplemented with trypsin, but this method is not routinely employed for diagnosis. Calyciviruses are not grown in culture. Unlike other adenoviruses, enteric adenoviruses, they are fastidious, but still they can be cultured in human embryonic kidney cell line. The serologic tests available for detection of IgG antibodies are enzyme linked immunosorbent assay, but they are available only for detection of IgG antibodies, so they are more suitable for serosurveillance of gastroenteritis viruses. Antibody neutralization assays, they are available for rotavirus. Coming to the management of viral gastroenteritis, because effective antiviral drugs are not available for the treatment, antiviral drugs are not used. So, the treatment is in the form of supportive care and maintenance of rehydration. So, restoration of electrolyte balance and rehydration therapy is the most important management that is required. Antibiotics play no role in the management of viral gastroenteritis. Prophylaxis in the form of vaccine is available for rotaviruses. Two types of vaccines are available. The first type of vaccine is a live oral vaccine, which is a reassortant rotavirus vaccine, which contains 5 reassortant strains, and these 5 strains are commonly circulating strains G1, G2, G3, G4 and P8. Now, this vaccine is given by oral route. 3 doses are given at 2, 4 and 6 months of age. The second type of vaccine available is attenuated monovalent vaccine, which contains a common strain of rotavirus, that is G1 P8 strain, and the commercially available vaccine is Rotarix. 2 doses are given orally at the age of 2 and 4 months. So, to summarize, we can say that viruses are one of the most important causes of acute gastroenteritis. They are most important cause of infantile and childhood diarrhea. Rotavirus is responsible for more than 75% of the cases of diarrhea in children. Norovirus is also associated with foodborne outbreaks, and rotavirus infection in children can be prevented by administration of vaccine during infantile period. Thank you.